Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing good. Specifically, if you are listening to this video during this COVID situation, just take care of yourself, follow the general guidelines, choose trust over everything. Everything is taken care of. We are going through a major transformation, so just to choose trust, okay? So I was just getting drawn to to deliver a message for somebody who want to understand something about themselves, something about their life. So there is a message from the universe, from the angels, from the guides, from the higher power, your higher self, or the highest consciousness, or any divine power you believe in. So just you have to select from three different set of cards. Before that, close your eyes, take a deep breath in and breathe out. And gently ask yourself, what is the message for you from the universe, from angels, from guides, from your higher self, or what do you need to understand? And just whenever you feel comfortable, open your eyes and you have to select from three different set of cards. The first set of cards is, I attract the essence of my thoughts. Second set of cards is, I can learn to prioritize my intentions. Third set of cards is, as I am segment intending, I am attracting. So either you can get drawn towards the images, or either you can be drawn towards the sentences that is mentioned on the card. There is no right and wrong. It's just that whatever you get drawn to, you may get multiple set of cards also. You may get drawn to multiple sets, and that is completely fine. Also, this is a general reading, so you may resonate, you may not resonate. Take whatever resonate, leave the rest. Till the time you are selecting, I would like to express my gratitude to all the people who have been following me on my social media, on YouTube, who have been sending me feedbacks, comments, who have subscribed the channel, who are listening for the first time. Thank you so much for being in my space. Thank you for all the love, encouragement, feedbacks. Thank you so much. It really means a lot to me. It just gives me more encouragement to do such kind of videos and also channelize messages for you. And so let's not delay this and let's start. I will be putting the timestamp below. You can just skip to whatever set of cards you have chosen. So first was just to go through it. I attract the essence of my thoughts. I can learn to prioritize my intentions. And third is, I am segment intending and I am attracting. I am segment intending, I am attracting. So it's nothing to do with right, wrong, good or bad. It's just that whatever you are getting, image or the words. So let's start the reading from the first set of cards. So the first set of cards is, I am attracting the essence of my thoughts. Back messages. The law of attraction and its magnetic power reaches out into the universe and attracts others throughout the vibrational like it, and brings that to you. And so you are getting the essence of what you are thinking about, whether it is something you want or something you do not want. Okay. Then it is Fool reverse. Then it is Nine of Cups reverse. What can you surrender? Surrender stress. Moon lightning. Athena, it's safe for you to be powerful. You know how to be powerful in a loving way that benefits others as well as yourself. Grace and Antoinette, I hope I am pronouncing it right. To help heal the situation, see the other person's point of view with compassion. This two cards I'll check later. And emotions. Okay, let me see. So the angels and the guides wants to tell you one thing is that you are stressing about something, specifically something about the other person in your life, because it has come with emotions and it has come with grace. So, and of course it has come with stress and something to do with maybe about your home environment or people related to your home. And because this is also very much I'm getting drawn to, so maybe there is something to do with your house, okay? So, or people living in the house, that is one thing. So the universe first message coming to you is that universe is telling you that whatever you are focusing on, universe is not judging you on the basis of what you are thinking, whether it is right, wrong, good or bad, whatever it is you are attracting, okay? And somewhere a part of you is feeling some kind of emotions which is giving you a stress. Okay, or it can be the stress is coming from the past experiences, past understanding, something to do with that you are not able to probably, I feel like this lady here is how she is open, right? Sorry. So I feel something to do with that you are not able to go with the flow, okay, or you are not able to understand some certain thing like why it happened or what will happen, okay? The card says take a few deep breaths and exhale the tension you have built up in your body. Let the stress go as you come back to your center. So some past emotions, some experiences you have stored in the body, okay? And this says me that you are going through this major transition or transformation in your life, which your body is showing you, okay? So your body is trying to tell you, let go of that stress, let go of something that is not working for you. It can be any experience, it can be any thought, it can be any emotion, anything that is not working for you. You have to choose being in your own power. So for being in your own power, to be in your own power, you have to let go of something that you have given power to. Specifically, if it is something to do with other people, it can be with your home, it can be with your workplace, it can be anything. Because if you give them the power about your thoughts, about your emotions, your understanding, your judgment, it will only bring you stress. Because the other person may understand, other person may not understand. And probably that is one of the reasons that you are finding it difficult to take any risk. You are finding it difficult to start something on new, like something that is new. It can be with your work, it can be with relationship, it can be anything. You are finding it difficult to start, okay, somewhere, because you are not able to trust the process of your wish fulfillment. Okay, I feel that somewhere you are not able to trust the process that your wish, that whatever wish you have, will be fulfilled. And every time I'm sensing that every time you are taking a step, one step, and then you are somehow taking two steps, like you are taking one step but then you are taking two steps backwards probably. Or it can be that every step that you are taking, you are not feeling that enthusiasm in you, okay? And that is also because somewhere you are not able to understand the other person's point of view, which is of course giving you stress. So it can be any area of your life. You have to let go of that stress. You have to let go of your opinion. You have to let the other person be right. You have to have a compassion towards that person, towards that situation. Because I always say this, you know, sometimes it's very important to have agreement with disagreements. It's not easy, because it's very easy that people agree to us and you know, people understand us. But it's not easy to accept people who don't understand us, or accept people who have a different point of view and still be in compassion. If you want to be in your true power, if you want to grow in your life, if you want to expand, if you want to have a different understanding, a different experience, a different probably anything that you want, where you want to grow, you know, you want to experience something which is very, you know, you all, if you see this angel or this is in the clouds, in the, you know, in the sky with the stars here, and here also the Fool card, if you see the person is in the sky, so you are probably trying to take that leap of faith and, you know, jump in the uncertainty so that your wish comes fulfilled. If you want to fly high, you have to let go of the stress, because stress is holding you back. See, if you see the figure, the person is trying to, you know, leave the ground probably, no, trying to fly high. Okay, so if you want to do that, if you want to achieve something, if you want the universe to fulfill the wishes that you have, first you have to let go of something, anything that is coming in your way with regards to your growth, in regards to your growth, you have to trust the process, you have to trust that universe is leading you towards the path. Also, for some of you, I feel, just take a pause. It's very important for your goals, for whatever you want to achieve in life, you need to take a pause, you need to take rest. The reason is you are letting go of something from the past, the stress, the emotions which the body has been trying to tell you from quite some time. So probably it can be in form of any restlessness, in form of anxiety, in the form of any disease or any kind of uneasiness or any kind of illness, sickness, anything. So if you have that, please acknowledge it. And that is also because, you know, somewhere you are holding back. This also tells me that is also coming because you are not able to come into your true power, something with your own power. You know that you are very powerful, you know that you can get something that you want, but your energy is depleted for 2 to 3 reasons. One is, of course, stress, which is also coming from what other people are thinking about you, what other people will say about it. It can be your dreams, it can be your relationship, it can be anything. So you are giving the other person the power to decide for you, right? Second thing I feel is that risk taking ability, okay, to take that risk, to take that leap of faith is not happening because the body is not allowing, or probably you are not allowing yourself. So just take rest, okay? Third thing is listen to other person's point of view with compassion. See, many times when we have overcome some emotion, which you have, I feel you have worked hard on yourself and you have come out of some situations, or you have worked on your previous, or you know, you have worked on some emotions in the past. So now what happens in the process, when we cross that stage, we lose patience at times because we understand from a different angle altogether now. And then the other person is not understanding in the same way. Maybe you are the one who is more mature in the situation or in your relation, but the other person is not understanding. So at that time, it's very important to have a compassion towards that person. And if at all you are not able to do that, then again, take a step back. Don't get involved, okay? Because universe is not giving you only what you want. It is giving you what you need in this minute, in this moment. And the universe is not judging you on the basis of the thoughts you have or on the basis of the emotions you have. It is just giving or granting you whatever you are thinking and whatever you are feeling, because your thoughts, your emotions, your actions are magnet towards whatever you attract. Okay, so trust in the higher power, trust in the process, okay, and let go of the stress. Okay, you can do this breathing exercises, which will really help you. Then they say moonlighting. You can start working on your dream career part-time while keeping your other jobs to pay the bills. Soon your dream career will take flight and fully support you. So if it is about your career and you are still worried about it, you have to start doing something which is on the basis of alternative, because it can be an alternative career or it can be any part-time thing. So you can always do your job, but at the same time do something which is part-time, which is your own, so that you can also use your own power. This also tells me that some of you are perfectionist. You are waiting for the perfect time, perfect period, perfect person to come in your space, or you being perfect in certain ability, capabilities, certain art form, anything, you know. There is nothing such as being perfect. You will always learn in the process. If you want to grow, start putting actions in, probably in baby steps, like here. Start taking risks, start taking baby steps, so that your wish comes fulfill. If you do that, it will no more be in the air, it will be in the action. Right? Also pay attention to the signs that you have, you see, you know, like any signs that you get from the universe. Pay attention to the signs, because universe is trying to guide you and help you. Let's see what is the message here. Wow, Lakshmi. Okay, let me read from this. So Lakshmi is an Hindu goddess who is known for giving abundance. So it says, goddess of abundance, fortune and beauty. Many call upon Lakshmi, but she only comes to few who have earned it. Today that is you. She is goddess of abundance, physical beauty, ojas, that is vital life force, good fortune and fertility. She is the sweetness of the fruit, the petals of the flower, the glistening of the ocean. She is extra spark. She is the extra spark that makes certain things beautiful. She comes to you with blessings of prosperity for the fruits of your labor. She has recognized your generosity and rewards you in her way, whether it is financial abundance, radiant health, loving partnership, a comfortable home, good fortune or impregnation you are seeking. Continue to give freely and lovingly, and so will she. So keep on giving people, keep on sharing, keep on giving whatever you can. So, and also at the same time, be open to receive. Pay attention to your thoughts, ideas, emotions, actions. Try and not control the situation. Try and let go of the stress, so that you can create space for something better, so that you can embrace your own power. Take baby steps towards your life, towards any goals that you have, specifically if it is something to do with work. Because if you are looking for an assurance that whatever you want to start will give you beneficial, like it will give you some benefits in money, then the assurance is yes, it will. Also, if it is something to do with counseling, healing, anything where you have to help people or share, you know, you also pursue that. That is one of the reason, because they are asking you to come in your true power to help others and also listen to them with compassion. Okay. Also, maybe because you have worked on yourself, so you understand other people's emotions, you understand other people's situation. Okay. Then I was asking what is the affirmation, that it says my wife speaks louder than my words. So once you let go of the stress, okay, once you understand your essence, your thoughts, your emotions, your your actions, everything, and you only focus on something good, okay? You come in your true power, okay? You understand and you the other person's point of view, and you agree with the disagreements. You have control over your own emotions, and you are not controlling anybody in your space. Taking baby steps in your life, okay? Trusting the process, okay? And understanding that whatever wish you have is divinely guided, is because you are aligned with the universe, you are aligned with the source, and it's okay to take that leap of faith, okay? It's okay to take pause, and Goddess Lakshmi is supporting you. You can ask her to help you to, even if you're looking for some finances, you know, like if you want some funding or anything, ask Goddess Lakshmi to help you and support you in this, okay, in this project, in this endeavors, because she is actually trying to help you. Just be open to receive. So this will always help you, that your vibes will attract your tribe, okay? Maybe you are in a major transformation. So it says that my vibe speaks louder than my words. I hope this was helpful for you. I really enjoy doing it. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading for you. We'll meet in some other time and space. Like and subscribe the channel. Share if you want to with other people. Let the message reach to other people. Stay at home, specifically during this period when you're listening. If you're listening during COVID period, lockdown period, so please stay at home. Thank you so much. Lots of love to you. Have an abundant life. We'll meet in some other time and space. Bye. Let's go to the next set of cards. I can learn to prioritize my intentions. It is important for you to identify which intention you most want to fulfill, because as you prioritize, you give your singular attention to what is most important. And as you give that your singular attention, by the law of attraction, you attract power into the intention that is most important to you. Wow. Okay, we'll come back. Then it is Seven of Wands in reverse. Okay, Seven of Swords in reverse. Surrender to what is. God is your source. Shanti. Azure. Azure. This I'll check later. Relationship dynamics. So first thing first coming to me is, you know, maybe you have been betrayed in some relation or some situation. You are not feeling good about it, or maybe you were trying to take a stand for something but you were not supported by the people or by the person, and you have fought some battle. If you see in both the cards, I feel the person is, you know, looking, yeah, the person is looking back, you know, like the person is not looking back. Probably we can see the back of the person, and there was some kind of situation where the person has stood or person has faced in his or her life. So it can be you, or it can be there is some person who is trying to do that for you. Okay, the main message I feel here is, because it has come with surrender to what is, which says flow with what is instead of fighting it. And if you can see, there is a battlefield, right? And they are saying flow with what is instead of fighting it. When you can't change a situation, compassionately accepting it exactly as it is will bring you peace. And it has come with the card Shanti, which is peace. So it says, I am an angel of peace, bringing you tranquility and smoother road ahead. So choose peace in any situation instead of fighting the situation, instead of trying to prove your point across, trying to make the other person understand what you feel, how you feel. Whether you are in the relationship or whether it is any situation in your workspace, specifically here it seems to be relationship, but it can be workspace also, where you're trying to stand for yourself, where you're trying to prove your point, where you're trying to make somebody understand something. And maybe you have stood for yourself in the past, you have tried and take that appropriate actions or steps in that direction, but it is not working. And the angels and the universe is trying to tell you is that, you know, go with the flow instead of fighting with it. Surrender to what it is rather than having a fantasy idea about something. Because for you need to understand what your intention is, and you need to prioritize and focus on that intention no matter what it is. Because here I feel a very strong sense of somewhere you're trying to control something again. Very much similar message to the set one, but little bit different in a different way. But if you are getting drawn to that also, then please check that. Because here it is relationship dynamics. So in relationship dynamics, you know, maybe you have to understand that what you understand or what you want or what you are trying to experience, or maybe help the other person to experience in your space, the person is not in that vibration, one. Second, if it is not about relationship, it can be generally in your life. You know, you have always tried to stand where you have always tried to, you know, avoid this betrayal or avoid some confrontations also, I feel. So, you know, you don't need to go in that energy of fighting. You can always choose peace. Also, it says, Azure, your desired outcome will occur in very near future. Have patience and faith and don't try to force it to happen. Again, go with the flow, they are saying. Don't try and make it, you know, try and make it or force it to happen. It won't happen that way. Everybody has their own pace. You can't make them, walk with you in a forceful manner. So you need to have patience. And then, because they want you to put your intention. So if you want something to resolve, or if you want something in your life, whether it is career or relationship or any money situation, anything, you have to prioritize what you are focusing on, because universe will give you what you focus on. So prioritize what you focus, because law of attraction always gives you what you focus on. Also, some of you, your dreams may be trying to tell you something, okay? And maybe very, very few people, maybe they may had some nightmares also. So you don't need to worry about that. Have patience. Also, here there is, you know, there is a clock. So just trust the divine timing, okay? Once you surrender to what is, okay? So here they are not saying that you don't have to see the reality of the situation, but after seeing the reality, you have to come in your power to change your intention and prioritize something that you want. One, second, trust the process. Third, choose peace in any situation. Okay. And then it says, God is the source. God is your source. Everything you need is supplied by the infinite source of God, and your faith opens the doorway to receive in God. There is no lack or limitations. Rather, there is plenty of abundance for all to share. So this says me that, you know, there is abundance for everything. Love, money, work, joy, peace, everything is in abundance. You have to prioritize that is your intention. One, you have to trust and have faith that God is your source and it will be making available for you. Okay, even if you want to resolve a relationship or a situation, or you want to come out of some relationship which was not so fruitful, or you want to enter into a new relation, whatever it is, God is your source. You have to have that faith, okay? And it will happen in the divine timing, and your outcome will be, I feel some of you, or probably all of you, will be very amazed when everything gets resolved or when you are at the better place or in a better situation, because you will understand the dynamics of the current situation or probably from the past situations in a very new light. You will learn the lessons and you will move and you will use the wisdom for your growth. So maybe a part of you is understanding, but a part of you is not yet understanding. So wait for the process to get over. Then pranayam. Okay, so this also says me do some breathing exercises, do some pranayam. You can always refer YouTube, or you know, if you have some yoga teacher or some yogic guru, you can follow that, because that will really help you to let go of something and also help you to in detoxification and cleansing. Okay, let's see what does this book says about that. So it says 8 stage of yoga, control of breath. You have inhaled the beauty, joy and magnificence of life and exhale the toxicity, stagnancy and dullness. Now is the time to use the prana energy you have cultivated deeper towards your truth. With this control of breath, you can control your life. So where would you like it to go? If you are seeking more rest, tranquility and luxury, breathe slower. If you are seeking more energy, speed and rajas in your life, breathe faster. Through pranayam, control breath, you can decide how you want to feel and when. Begin the study of various pranayam practices such as alternate nostrils breathing and breath of fire. Use it in your life to magnetize your directions. This is so beautiful. Your breathing will actually help you. I'm sorry, the card has fallen down. I'll pick it up later. So the breathing will actually help you to magnetize to whatever you want. It will help you to let go of whatever is not serving you. It will help you to open to receive, because God is your source. What happens is whenever we have gone through some problems, situations, and we all have somewhere or the other. No life is easy and no life is difficult. It is all about how you take life, right? So whatever it has been in the past, it is past, it's over. It will not repeat, first thing first. Whatever it was, it is over. At the same time, they want you to inhale and exhale and do some pranayam, because it will help you to focus on the intention that you want. It will just shift whatever it is. Okay, your thoughts, your emotions, your situations, your actions, everything will shift. In fact, your dynamics, your relationships will also shift. So probably many of you are going through this transformation in their relationship. And so what is the affirmation you can do, or what is the message from the universe? This is one of my favorite decks. The universe has your back. Once I accept the love of the universe as my primary teacher, I will always be guided back to light. So once you understand that the love of the universe is your primary teacher, okay? So maybe in the past you may be operating from the fear-based energies or from the energies of victimhood, but now they are saying you have to come in the winner role, you have to choose peace, you have to let love of the universe be your teacher. See, many of you maybe, you know, have maybe had a belief that that only pain will help me to learn and grow. So it's not wrong, but it is not working with for you anymore. So you can always learn to choose with love rather than learning through pain. Because it says universe, love of the universe as my primary teacher, I will always be guided back to the light. So no matter how many battles you have fought, no matter how much you have stood, or no matter nobody stood for you, no matter somebody betrayed you or you had some kind of dynamics in the relationship which was not making you feel good about yourself, or you felt betrayed somewhere, you don't need to worry about it. Because when you choose love, when you focus on your intentions, okay, when you understand that what is your priority in your life, you surrender to what is, you are doing this pranayam, which is inhaling and exhaling, and the card which fall down has God is your source. When you have that faith, when you choose peace, okay, nothing can stop you to have your desired outcome, right? I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading, and this was wonderful for me to do this reading. We'll meet in some other time and space. If you like the reading, please do like, subscribe. If you want, you can share with other people. And we'll meet in some other time and space. Bye. Love you. Have an abundant life. Let's go to the third set of cards, which is I am segment intending, I am attracting. This is the way you feel is your point of attraction, and so the value of segment intending is that you pause many times during your day to say, this is what I want and expect from this segment of my life experience. And as you set forth those powerful thoughts, you will attract into your experience that you want. Today all three set of cards are very much interconnected, so if you got drawn to the first any two, please check that, because the intention or the message is more or less very similar. They are saying that you need to, every day you have to say this, that this is what I want. So you have to choose what you want, and then you have to say that this is what I want and I expect from this segment of my life experience. Whatever you will put focus on, you will give power to it. Okay. So it's like you give power to one thought, you will attract more such thoughts. And you, if you feed one thing, here the person is feeding a bird. So if you feed one bird, you will attract more such kind of birds, which will give you more, you know, like whatever you, for you, whatever the birds represent. It can be a positive thought or intention or anything that you want in life. So whatever you will feed, it will go on increasing and expanding, and you will keep on attracting that. And then Six of Wands in reverse. The Hermit. Surrender resentments. No more complaining. Desire. I'll read the cards. Archangel Michael. And leaving. So I feel very clear message that you are leaving the past behind. You are letting go of something that is not working for you. If you haven't, then you have to let go of that. And you have to also, they are saying that no conditions are unfavorable right now. Wait or look into another option and ask the angels to help you, guide you and comfort you. So do not be in rush. Do not hurry. Do not hurry the process. Do not try and take everything on your platter at a time. Take baby steps, pause. It's okay to take your time. Go within, contemplate, okay? Understand the various dynamics of the situation. Leave whatever is not serving you, okay? And choose something where you are choosing from love for yourself and others. Also see that what you have learned or what you can learn from the situation. See from different angles, from your angle, from the other person's angle, from the other side of the situation. So be cautious about it, okay? Do not try and hurry first thing first, because you need to understand what you are intending. Your intentions, you need to be very clear with your intention, the segment of intentions that you have, you are feeding that, okay? It's not like right, wrong or negative, positive, but probably somewhere it is coming from resentment. And whenever we operate or we have this resentment towards money, towards people, towards ourselves, towards anything, you know, when we have resentment, we are not able to take the right step. That is the reason maybe they are saying that no, the conditions are not favorable, because maybe wherever you are operating from, somewhere it is also coming from complaining, you know, resentment and complaining, and then it is saying cautious. So they want you to just take a pause and contemplate, okay, do not rush, okay, leave. You have to understand and leave something which is not serving you, specifically resentment, okay. Let me read the cards for you. So holding on to resentment only poison you. Try to forgive others for their shortcomings and keep moving forward towards positive situation in your life. I am not sure if I should share this, but this reminds me of one of the past life regression of myself, and I do work on myself on the daily basis. So if you don't believe it, it's just 2 minutes, I'll try and share, and if you can understand. So I was holding a resentment for a particular person in my life, and I didn't understand that why that person is always angry. So I was not sure if I was angry with the person, but so recently I faced one challenge, and when I was working on myself, there was lot of, you know, sadness. Also there was lot of, I think, anger, because below anger there is always sadness, or probably something that has not gone as per our liking, okay, specifically if it is about other person. And when I was working on myself, I understood in one of my life I had acted from the place of greed, and that greediness had made me taken a path of revenge, of something that I should not do, okay. And that got carried forward in this life in a kind of one situation, and I was not able to understand why the resentment was so deep that I was not able to forgive the person. So many times when we are not able to forgive somebody, it may be coming from deep rooted resentment for self also, because it's like a karma that you are going through. So when I was trying to understand myself, I understood that why I was going through that and why I was not getting the appreciation from that person, because it is coming from my own karma, right? And that leads to complaint, that why I am not able to get that, okay. So we have to understand that we need to leave that situation. So how I resolved is a very different way of doing it, but you can always choose in the moment. You can always go within and choose in the moment that segment that you want. So I did some healing about it, and then I understood that I don't need to be in complaint. I can always choose to let it go. I can always take actions. Like, I can always take baby steps. So similarly for you, take baby steps. Wait, don't be in a hurry, because it will not give you the desired result. Though, you know, if you take pause, if you want that appreciation, if you want to grow, if you want to go forward in your life, if you want to, whether it is relationship, whether it is your money, whether it is your love life, whether it is your work, job, anything, okay? So choose coming from where is it coming from, and let go of something, because here it says reverse of this. So you are not getting the credit of something that you are doing for the person, for the situation, for the job or anything, you know, you are not getting the credit, and that is just making you feel more complaining, that is making you hold resentment. So wait, pause, don't be. And also somewhere I feel a part of you is in pleasing. So pleasing doesn't help us to resolve anything. So come out of that pleasing. You don't have to do anything from the pleasing attitude of your life, because pleasing always comes from fear, and you have to work from love. Fear will not resolve anything. Fear will always make you stick to that situation, and it is like a repetitive pattern which will again bring more deeper resentment, okay. So no more complaining says, complaints are affirmations of victimhood, And I was just mentioning about my story or my experience which I recently resolved. So it is when we come from the victimhood, we cannot have results of the winners, right? So it says, complaints are affirmations of victimhood which is never true spiritually. Take back your God-given power by affirming that you have an abundance of choices and freedom. With your increased confidence and assertiveness, watch this positive affirmation blossom into reality. Okay, I hope this was helpful. Let's see what does the yogic path say. So it says, savadhya, savadhya. Let's see what is the literal meaning. Savadhya. Okay. Savadhya is niyam, that is self-study. And I was just telling you, right, self-study, going within. And I had also resolved my situation in a similar manner. Yes. Yes. So we were each born with book of infinite wisdoms. Wisdom, stories, inventions and emotions. This book is our own consciousness. So here if you see, there is a book. Okay. So this book is our own consciousness. If we take the path to truly study the self, we will never become bored with our findings. Instead of trying to acquire more information, take the focus inward. There are cosmoses in your consciousness you have yet to venture into that have more beauty than any artwork, more mystery than your favorite thriller, more magnificence than all earthly creations. However, the passport required to reach these vistas is stillness. Through withdrawing from external stimulus, you can move into true stimulus, the world inside and beyond you. This is so beautiful, right? So spend some time within, spend some time in a hermit mode. It will help you to come out of that resentment. You will understand the deeper meaning as I was explaining my story. So when I learned that it was coming from my past life where I had done something wrong, automatically the resentment dissolves. Right? I don't know if you will have a similar experience, but at least you will understand the deeper aspect of it so that you can let go of this resentment. And whenever we do this let go of resentment, whenever we do forgiveness, believe me, you are not doing for others, you are doing for yourself. The other person is already free. Probably the other person doesn't care because he or she is already moving in life, or maybe not moving, or maybe affected, maybe not affected, but the most person who is affected is you. So it's your choice to let go. Then it says, Archangel Michael, I am with you, giving you courage to make life changes that will help you work on your divine life purpose. So this self-study will also help you to go within and understand what is your purpose. So maybe you have a bigger purpose in your life which you need to fulfill. Keep on connecting Archangel Michael for that. And keep on having that segment of intentions, because that will help you to keep on attracting what you have, what you want. Then it says, and I just mentioned that in the past you may have chosen from fear. The affirmation is, I recognize that I have chosen fear and I choose again, I choose love. So maybe in the past, whatever choices you have made, it from this life, any other life, whatever, you had made choice from the fear. Now you don't need to make the same choice, because that fearful choices has made you feeling victim, which has made you stuck in the situation, which has made you felt unappreciated or made you felt unworthy, which has made you go through this resentment. So now you are choosing from love. You choose self-worth, self-esteem. You go within try and understand, study from within the consciousness, the wisdom that you carry from many lifetimes, from your higher self, highest consciousness. You don't need to be in complaint. Complaint comes from victimhood. You cannot get the results of winner. Wait. Do not take any actions. Don't take any drastic steps specifically. Okay. Leave anything that is not serving you. Okay. Choose peace. Choose love. Because now you are operating from love. In a day, choose the segment of thoughts. Focus and prioritize. Ask Archangel Michael to help you specifically to let go of the resentments and to connect to your divine life purpose. Okay. So this was the reading for people who have selected set 3. I hope this was helpful for you. I really enjoyed doing it. Thank you so much for being in my space. Lots of love to you. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading for you. We'll meet in some other time and space. Like, subscribe if you want. You can share with other people also. And we'll meet in some other time and space. Have an abundant time. Lots of love to you. Bye.